next match is mixed doubles, and it is the three-time former champions Jochen Fischer-Nielsen and Christina Pedersen up against a young Chinese pair who were in five consecutive Super Series tournament finals, Cheng Shiwei and Cheng Ching Chen. And then after that, we finish with the second of the men's doubles semi-finals. Chen Ching Cheng saying to her partner, come on, get up, we've got to go and play the semi-final now. Of course, both of the women involved in this mixed doubles semi-final have played earlier today in women's doubles. Christina Pedersen lost her semi-final with Camilla Yule, whereas Chen Ching Cheng won hers with Xia Yifan. So mixed doubles semi-final, former champions against the 19-year-olds from China.
This is the Dubai World Super Series Finals mixed doubles second semi-final. Let's hear it for the players. First out, the number three seeds from Denmark, Jochen Fischer-Nielsen and Christina Pedersen.
The three-time former champions won the title in 2009, 12 and 2013 as well, making their seventh appearance here at the Super Series Finals. The left and right-handed combination, former world number ones, can they do it again?
And let's hear it for their opponents, the number four seeds from China, Chen Shiwei and Chen Qingchen.
Chen Shiwei and Chen Qingchen. What an extraordinary year they've had. They played one Super Series event in 2014. That was their home event, where they reached the semi-final. They didn't play any Super Series tournaments last year because they were still juniors. This year, they played eight events and they reached five consecutive finals, from Australia to the French Open. And from those five finals, they've won two titles, the Japan Super Series, and then their second Super Series title was indeed in Paris. These two pairs met in the final of the Denmark Premier Super Series, and they wind the Danes on home soil. Meant that they have won at least one Super Series title every year since they formed their partnership. That's nine straight years. For a pair to keep that sort of consistency is truly remarkable, especially when you consider that Jochen Fischer-Nielsen had about 8 months out with a knee surgery. There he is, the oldest man in the tournament, a 38-year-old from Copenhagen. 1 week as world number ones from the 2nd of April last year. This year finished three on the Super Series standings and the number six on the world ranking at the moment. Only nine Super Series tournaments this year for the Danish combination, but two finals, winning Denmark and being beaten in the final of the All England Championships. Christina Pedersen, 30 years of age, and as I say, this is the ninth year of their partnership. Two World Championship bronze medals, an Olympic bronze medal from London 2012, and here you can see their matches so far. In the very first match on Wednesday, they beat the world number ones and the finalists from last year, Go Sung Hyung and Kim Ha Na. On Thursday, they beat the Olympic champions Tontoi Ahmad and the injured Liliana Nasir. And then yesterday, they lost to Praveen Jordan and Debbie Susanto, who was the pair, of course, that beat them in the All England final. And that Indonesian combination lost earlier today to the defending champions, Mr. and Mrs. Adcock. So to Chen Qingcheng, 19 years of age, born in Meizhou in eastern Guangdong province. Not the tallest of athletes, 164. That's about 5'4.5". Her partner is also 19 years of age. He's from Wenzhou in Xinjiang province on the east coast of China. Current world number threes have been as high as two in their first full year on the senior tour. That is remarkable, isn't it? They beat the number two seeds on Wednesday, their teammates in three games, Lu Kai and Wang Yaxiong. Then they beat the defending champions, Chris and Gabby Adcock, who are already through to the final tomorrow, before yesterday beating the number eight seeds, Kasuno and Kurahara, in two straight games. So this is the third meeting between the two pairs, and of the previous two, it's the Danes that have won on both occasions. The last time was that final in Denmark at the Premier Super Series event. 21-16, 22-20 in 47 minutes. David Wong from Malaysia, our umpire. And Faditomo Kashihara of Japan, our service judge.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Joachim Fischer Nielsen, Christina Pedersen, Denmark. And on my left, Zhang Xi Wei, Chen Qingcheng, China. Chen Qingcheng to serve to Joachim Fischer Nielsen, love all, play.
Well, the former world junior champions from China getting this mixed doubles semi-final underway. Chen Xiwei and Chen Qingchen, one of three mixed doubles pairs this year to win a maiden Super Series title. Other pairs to do so, Lu Kai and Wang Yaxiong in India, and of course Praveen Jordan and Debbie Susanto at the All England Championships. Well, he is incredibly fast, Chen Xiwei.
1-0.
And the problem, I think, for the Danes, Steen, is how do you neutralise that, especially when Chen Qingcheng at the front of the court, as we saw from the women's doubles, well, she's incredibly strong from the front court area as well.
Yeah. But I think the Danes, they are... I think they're confident because they don't want to play with a whole lot of pace. They want to control the rallies. The question is, how much have Zhang Xiwei and Chen Qingchen learned from the last two, or from the previous two encounters, on how to play these Danes here?
Service over, 2-0.
I've really been looking forward to this match because I have a feeling that at least the Danes, you won't get them to say it, but I have a feeling that they feel they're playing the final here. I think they are confident that they have a good grip on the Adcocks, who's already in the final. And that could bring extra nerves, in my opinion.
Yeah.
3.
I don't know the head-to-head statistics for Zhang Xiwei and Chen Qingchen, except they beat Chris and Gabby Adcock in straight games in the
group stage.
Yeah.
They also beat them in the final of the Bitburger Grand Prix Gold earlier this year.
So, but I mean, as we've seen, it's not always a bad thing to be the underdog.
No. No, she enjoyed that, didn't she?
4 two.
Well, a year ago, Cheng Shiwei was awarded the Eddie Chung Most Promising Player of the Year award. This year, it's his partner that's won the award, this lady.
Yeah.
It's gone long. Well, there's a challenge here from Cheng Shiwei. I find that strange. I thought that was a long way out. Well, he's the youngest male player in the tournament, is Cheng Shiwei. And he's playing against the oldest player in the tournament in Jochen Fischer Nielsen. Youth versus experience. Now, what does Hawkeye say? Yeah, long way out. Crikey, why did you challenge that? Yeah. Very odd
challenge
decision.
Unsuccessful. One challenge remaining.
Will be
service over. Three,
very important
four,
for the Chinese pair to sort of make use of their speed, and they best do that by being in control of the rallies and attacking. And likewise for the Danes, they want to take the pace out of the rallies until they have a really good attacking chance.
Clever.
Good clear.
Oh, what a good rally. Brilliant.
And look at the high lifts. The Danes, they feel the high lift. They neutralize the attack from Zhang Xiwei. He's very, very fast on his feet. So if he can jump into the rally, jump into the shot and make this quick attack, then he's dangerous.
Four.
But he's not hitting that hard when the shuttle drops from the ceiling.
Did awfully well to control
four,
that. It was a long old rally, wasn't it? Played at pace.
Yeah.
Exciting. Yeah, 42 shots.
And as we know, in Denmark Open, there's no air condition, so very, very little drift and almost perfect playing conditions. That means you can lift with accuracy from both sides. So gave Fischer and Pedersen good conditions for winning that match.
Service over.
Five, not sure where the first match was played.
I know it was earlier this year, and it was two games, and I think it was in the first round of the Indonesian Super Series.
Play.
It was, Jill. Perfect memory, and that hole should, in my opinion, benefit the Chinese players. Because it's very difficult to play in East Oresanai, and there's a lot of drift and difficult drift to figure out because it's different from court to court.
Yeah, that's just beautiful, isn't it? Wonderful
seven,
change of pace from Cheng Shiwei.
So far, I think Zhang and Chen has succeeded in getting the Danes to play this reasonably fast-paced mixed doubles.
Good return.
Service over.
I'm not sure I'd serve to the tee when the left-hander is in the left-hand corner.
No.
Yeah, look at that. Not sure if we saw that, but I can tell you that Zheng Siwei just practiced the serve towards the centre of that left-hand court, as if to say, yeah, I did serve to the wrong place, should have served out wide more.
Six, seven.
Both of the Chinese players at the World Junior Championships last year won two gold medals each. Zheng Jiwei, men's doubles with her Jiting. And of course, as we were talking earlier, Chen Qingcheng with her partner that she won her semi-final with earlier today, Jia Yifan.
Six, seven.
I think this year, He Jiting actually took the mixed doubles title.
I think you're right. Come on, back level.
Seven all.
It's almost as if he's already on his way to the middle of the court before he's finished his shot, Zheng Siwei.
It's a pity from a Danish perspective.
Deng.
Looking to reach her seventh final at the Super Series finals. Pedersen.
Yeah. The Danes with the most Super Series titles of all players.
Yeah.
Service over. Eight. All.
Joachim Fischer, second on that list, so they've won quite a bit together.
13 in total. Yeah. 23 finals as a mixed doubles competition. Combination, I think I was trying to say. Oh, that's better.
That was a lucky shot from Chen Qingchen. She knows it.
Yeah. So over.
She almost
Nine.
Stopped the rally. Because she couldn't stop laughing. There was the service from Zheng Siwei. It was actually directing it a little bit upwards to the clear forehand side of Joachim Fischer. That's interesting, Chen Qingchen, she doesn't move back when Christina Pedersen is attacking on the flick serve.
A three-point advantage for the teenagers.
Joachim Fischer noticing that the Chinese pair were not trying to lift over him today as they did in the final in Denmark Open. Trying to play below the tape in front of him instead. Good coverage by Christina Pedersen.
Service over. 9, 11.
He is
service
fast.
Over.
Zhang Siwei.
12, 9.
Got himself in a perfect position there for that smash on the flick serve of Joachim Fischer.
Well, 13-9. Change.
First match was a bit of a mishit from Joachim Fischer,
13.
But he got another chance, and that one was a little bit of a mishit. But this one leaves no chance for Chen Ching Chen. Rotation there by Chen
14,
and Zhang.
10.
Now she's ready. Dane's expecting a smash.
It's a good serve.
I think she may have been distracted by the
15,
movement of her opponent
10.
Because that came off the frame of the racket. Chen Chen coming forward, that may have just distracted Pedersen.
Yeah. I don't know what she was trying to do because she was actually positioned quite a bit in the left service field. So in my opinion, she should have just blocked it.
16-10. Service over. 11-16.
Wants the court mopped.
So gives them time to recompose the thoughts.
Thank you.
And only two pairs doing the home Super Series mixed doubles event this year. And the ones go so far in Kanahana, the other pair to win a home event, obviously in Korea.
11-16.
And this is a time of the match where I wouldn't be surprised if the Danes took a small run of points. The Chinese, they really got to keep their concentration because I think they feel they've got it under control.
Oh my goodness, what on earth happened there? It's gone long.
Yeah.
She must have expected him to take it.
No, I think she couldn't smash. I think he was too close to where she was going to smash. Yeah. Yeah, he moves back.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah. That's nice. She's got such concern for her partner. I didn't want to hit him.
Exactly what I was referring to. You get a little bit content, you have a good lead, and had this been 15 all or something like that, you would have been firing on all cylinders and really be looking to retrieve that shot. Ooh, that's a costly mistake.
Service over. 17-13.
The three first days, I thought Christina Pedersen covered that forehand corner brilliantly, but she hasn't done well today. I'm thinking about whether the performance in the women's doubles, where they had virtually no chance against Masutomo and Takahashi, whether that's 13. Affecting her a little bit also in the mixed.
Well, of course, Pedersen is the only player in Super Series Finals history to win two titles at the same Super Series Finals. That was 3 years ago.
13.
And Chen Qingcheng, if she's to win, if she wins this semi-final, has a chance to emulate that. At age 19, that'd be something special, wouldn't it? But this mixed doubles semi-final is far from finished.
Service over. 14.
19. Fabulous.
Very imaginative play by Chen Qingcheng.
Looking. 20. Game point, 14.
Game point opportunities. Six of them for the number four seeds. Oh, look at that.
Game.
What a super backhand.
21-14.
In 21 minutes. 21-14. Gosh, they're looking sharp, aren't they? A year ago, they didn't play any Super Series.
Heroppe ved jeg ikke, men her nethøjde eller under, hun drejer ikke, hun spiller bare lige ud. Så kan godt være, hun ligger den, men det mest ligger hun kort eller lige forbi. Men
PT
har jeg haft to smash.
Ja, det er også det.
Så det er
tilbage til det. 20 seconds.
Mm. He's using all of that time out there. Lots of information and lots of discussion from the Danes. Now, don't forget to follow us on hashtag Badminton Dubai.
Second game. Love all. Play.
Now, there was lots of talking there from the Danes. Steen, what exactly was being said?
Yeah, there were a couple of things. Mainly they were way too defensive. The Chinese had succeeded in sort of pushing them back on the court. They needed to come forward. The first lift was of too low quality. Needed to lift high to Zhang Xiwei. And Joachim Fischer said, my tension level is too low.
Oh, certainly an intense rally now.
Yeah. They had some observations on that the Chinese pair was not doing like the Indonesians normally do, move the Danes from side to side. They were merely playing back at them, and they were trying to exploit that. But they wanted to come forward on court and get the attack a bit more. Joachim Fischer had to be more animated and invested in the game.
Well, if you've watched Joachim Fischer Nielsen previously, you'll be, a little bit surprised about that, because I think he's one of the most animated players. And for him to feel that he hasn't got his energy level up, because I think that's what I love about watching him, is that he's so intense. He gives so much effort all of the time that for him to feel that his energy levels aren't there.
That would still mean for a whole lot of other players that it would be too high.
Yeah.
But for Joachim, it's not enough. He's got to live and die with this match.
Yeah.
Okay. Service over. 3-2.
I noticed in the first game that the Chinese pair were very deliberate about getting Chen Qicheng forward to the net. When she was at the backcourt, she wasn't really attacking that much. I think I've seen them where Chen Qicheng is not afraid of attacking from the backcourt and sort of playing in the reverse positions. Okay. They didn't want to do that here against the Danes.
No, if the Danes want to.
You want to change it fast, okay? Yeah.
Well, ask me first if all the players on courts want to change the shuttle. Save time if they just quickly changed it and got a new one.
Did he miss that, Joachim?
So yes, he did.
But he had the correct read.
Yes.
And what the Danes discussed in the interval is true. She just plays it straight. And that's exactly the idea. If you have a read, then go with it, cover that shot, force your opponent to make a more difficult shot that she perhaps is not comfortable with making.
Oh, that's a super shot, isn't it? Mid-court area.
There's a demonstration of what the mid-court area means in mixed doubles. That's a shot like this. Comes here.
Pass.
And there I like it there. He commits to staying on the side. He's not on his way back to the middle or anything. That's so important. If you commit to your shot, you make better quality. Better quality shot, of course.
Service over. Four all.
Watch Chen Qingcheng's reaction after she misses this one. Ah, lost. No.
Well played.
Yeah.
5-4.
It was very quick on that one, Joachim Fischer. And that's totally in line with the, what the Danes decided they wanted to do in the interval.
Confusion between the two Chinese players there. Who's going back which side to defend? Yeah. Nice change of pace from Joachim Fischer. Watch this, they're both going back to the right-hand side of the court initially. Good rally. Oh, yeah, the call from Christina Pedersen. Yeah, he was undecided, wasn't he?
Zane? Peter? Come, players, come here.
Well, the umpire's going to have a word and please tell them to.
Zane?
Please, no walk around the court, okay?
Yeah, down to walk around the court in between the rallies.
7-5.
Good smash placement from Zhang Siwei. Placed so that if the Danes retrieve it,
6-7,
he's able to continue the attack.
Awareness. It's not just about the interceptions, the variation on pace and awareness of whether opponents are back on their heels or where the weaknesses are. It's an instinctive player, isn't she?
Yeah. But I think she's blocking off a lot more today than we saw her in Denmark Open. And of course, if she's not doing that, then Danes are blocking. So it's actually a very, very important role she has today, Chen Qingcheng.
8-7.
Oh, now it's the turn of the Danes to both go for the same shot.
May, please.
Good change of pace again, wasn't it? Lovely drop.
Yeah.
9-7.
She's struggling a little bit. Christina Pedersen in the defense when she's moved. But there's also great shot quality on the drop shots from the Chinese pair.
Service over. 8-9.
He does deal with that serve to the tee when he's in the left-hand court. Very well indeed, the left-hander.
Service over.
Good return.
10-8.
Five of the last 6 points.
Oh, that was going wide. Good shot.
Service over.
Joachim is showing what she did. She reversed it. He seemed, you can do that shot, actually. It was like he was really, really surprised. They've been playing for 9 years. He looks confused. What happened? How did you go there? Oh, you twisted it a little bit.
Good serve.
Wait. Both things went for that.
Oh, it's wide. And it's the Chinese youngsters who have the advantage in the game interval. Only 2 points advantage this time, whereas they had 3 points in the opening game.
11-9.
Yeah.
Play.
Ken Johnson saying to his players, we're almost there. It's just one big run of points that's bringing them back into this second game here. We're almost there. And there was a little bit of discussion in the end of the interval. Christina Pedersen, I couldn't really hear what she was saying, but it was something that if she couldn't make a move towards the net, she was losing a little bit of her confidence.
10-11.
Instinctive, you want to save it.
Look, he doesn't really take a step, though. He just leaps.
No, just jumps.
It just jumps.
Great control.
Yeah.
13-10.
He played the easy shot, and the Danes were expecting something extraordinary. And it was, but it was because it was simple.
Oh, sir.
Service over. 11-13.
Yeah, it skimmed the net, didn't it?
Good move by Joachim Fischer. That puts pressure on Chen Qingchen, and she misses that drop shot.
Drop long.
Service over. 14-12.
Nice, that was clever from Pedersen.
Service over. 13-14. Joachim? Joachim,
come held it to the last moment.
Joachim, I say no is no. You use your play, 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 play.
All right, he's just pointing out that his shirt is sodden with perspiration and therefore trying to wrap his face with his shirt, it's not really going to achieve an awful lot.
Very alert by Zhang Siwei. Serve.
Service over. 14-16.
Absolutely pounced on this. Look how early he took that. Of the smash, isn't it? There's the awareness that I was talking about.
Yeah.
Could see that Pedersen was committed to her backhand defense and therefore aimed towards her right shoulder.
And standing a little bit too far back. That was something the Danes discussed. Seems they are a little bit intimidated by the Chinese attack.
15-17.
Yeah, it's a good flick serve. Yeah. Very good flick
16,
serve.
17.
Oh, that's good to see from the Danes. If the opponents want a new shuttle, I'm happy with a new one. What a terrific serve. Yeah. What a shot.
Service over. 18-16.
But his right, Kenny Johnson, the Danes, they're almost there. Should they manage to steal this second game, it's one game all, and they've got as good a chance as anybody.
Yeah.
Oh, oh, fantastic.
Unbelievable backhand.
Good rallies.
Yeah. Very good rally. So what an incredible save on the deep backhand corner 18. From Cheng Shiwei. Look at this. How on earth did he control that? Just 1 point in it now. You're right, Steve. They are very nearly
17,
on level terms.
18.
This is a good return of serve, good pressure 19, from 17. Chen Ching Chen. 2 point advantage and 2 points away from the final. Good return.
Okay. 18-19. Hey! Service over. 20.
Well,
match point.
Yeah, we're 18. On the third shot, and it means that there's match point opportunities for Chen Shiwei and Chen Ching Chen. And on their first opportunity, they convert and record their first ever victory over the three-time former champions, Jochen Fischer-Nielsen and Christina Pedersen. 21-14, 21-18 in 47 minutes. And the world junior champions for the year
match
ago.
Won by Zheng Jiwei, 21-14, 21-18.
And will contest the final tomorrow. That is a remarkable first year achievement in world badminton. Oh, yeah. Two straight games. No. They didn't lose a match in their group. They've been superb throughout, and for this young lady, Chen Ching Cheng, she will be contesting two finals tomorrow, women's doubles and mixed doubles as well. What a performance. Sets up a final with the defending champions, Chris and Gabby Adcock, who won the title a year ago. It's their first appearance in a Super Series tournament final since that final a year ago. And they're up against a pair who will be appearing in their sixth Super Series tournament final this year when making their first appearance at the Super Series finals. What a story for the Chinese youngsters. So just one more semi-final to come, one more men's doubles, and then all final places will be decided. It's the two-time beaten finalists over the last 2 years, Chai Biao and Hong Wei, up against the Olympic silver medalists, Govi Shen and Tam Wee Kyong of Malaysia. So there are the Chinese pair. Oh, crikey, there's a fair bit of strapping on the Achilles of Hong Wei. We didn't see that yesterday. And here, their opponents, the Olympic silver medalists. And of course, for Chai Biao and Hong Wei, they ended the Olympic Games fourth. They lost the bronze medal playoff match. And having been beaten in the final of the Super Series finals for the last 2 years, they're trying to